This world is as it is for all of us. How you wish to see it will determine your level of happiness. There was a grandfather living in Hyderabad. When grandmother passed away, he said, what to do? Should I spend 3 months with each of my children through the year? Rather than trouble them, let me stay in an old age home. So he found a good old age home in Hyderabad and went to speak to the manager that I'd like to purchase an apartment here. The manager finalized the contract, selected the room for him. And then he said to the nurse, show grandfather his new room. The nurse accompanied grandfather, guided him to his apartment, and she was cheering him up on the way. Dadaji, you know, this room of which we have got for you, it has got a brick fireplace that looks so nice. Grandfather said, I love it. The nurse said, Dadaji, we have also got a Persian carpet there and the design is so exquisite. He said, fantastic. The nurse said, Dadaji, there's a Chinese vase with flowers in it. He said, I just love it. The nurse said, Dadaji, you have not even seen that apartment as yet. How can you say that you love it? He said, look, my child, whether I love it or not does not depend upon the apartment. It depends upon me. Think about it very carefully. He's saying whether I love it or I don't love it does not depend upon the apartment. It depends upon me. So similarly in this world, you choose to be happy or you choose to be unhappy does not depend upon the situations. It just depends upon the choices that you make. And when we are unhappy, we are the ones who are choosing to be unhappy. Living in this world, the God-realized saints chose to see God. And hence the gopis said, Vatan me, ghatan me, vithin me, bagan me, belin me, vatika me, phoolan me, van me, daran me, divarin me, dehari darichan me, heeran me, haran me, bhushan me, tan me, kanan me, kunjan me, gopin me, gayan me, gokul me, godhan me, damini me, ghan me, jahan jahan dekhu tah sham hi dikhai det, mero sham chhai rahyo nainan me, man me. The gopis are saying, wherever we look, we see the divine form of our Lord Krishna. Living in this world, the saints saw God. Ishavasyamidam sarvam yat kincha jagatyan jagat. The Ishopanishad says, everywhere is the form of God. Lord Shiv told Mother Parvati, Uma je Ram charan rat vigat kam mad krodh nij prabhu maya dekhahi jagat kehi san karhi virodh. He says, O Parvati, that fortunate soul who has removed desire, anger, greed from within sees this world as the veritable form of God. What does that mean? It means there are two realities in existence. One is the objective reality. The other is the subjective reality. The objective reality is the world made of earth, water, fire, air, and sky. That is the same for us all. The subjective reality is how we are looking at it. So if we are unhappy, the defect is not in the world. The defect is in our perspective. And if we wish to become happy, all we need to do is to change our thoughts. It is so simple. We are always struggling with the outside. Unless this person changes, I cannot be happy. Unless my boss's behavior becomes different, I cannot be happy. Unless this patient responds in this manner, I cannot be happy. We are assuming that the key to our happiness is on the outside. And the moment that is our assumption, then people and circumstances can switch us on and switch us off. But if we take away the key which we have given to others and keep it with ourselves, we can always choose our happiness.